who is SXM Academics? I personally know who SXM Academics is. Or to be exact, the people hiding behind that account, man. I know who are the individuals behind that account.
I got money, I can buy you some Gucci Chanel. I know all about you, I see boss à la Chanel. My money is right, my money is real. I'ma treat you right, like my clientele. I be selling weed, I know you can smell. If you're gonna ride with me, promise not to tell. Never sit in jail, I got money for the bill. 300 for your hair and 180 for your nail. Fuck your body count, can your money count?
Yo, so what is up? You know I still look good as fuck even though I don't have dreads anymore. All whips. Sad boy still in the cut. And today, specialized video. I haven't posted in a while. I will admit it. Because my nigga, I have a life other than YouTube. I have to go to school. I have to go to work. I have to study. I got personal things that I have to go through and deal with. So excuse me, madame et monsieur. Wow. But before I stop with the Robinson Shigui whole TV show, I promise y'all that I was going to expose that bitch ass nigga SM Academics. And the wait is over, man. OVA, over. Bitch, I found you. I finally found you, bitch. Bitch, you hear me good? You hear me good? You hear me good? You hear me good? Bon. I remember I promised a lot of people that I would find out who SXM Academic is in a matter of a month or two times. Because I got shit to do. YouTube is not the only thing I just do, you know? But the wait is over, my nigga. The wait is over. You see, I still look cute. I still look decent. So to start the video, I'm going to talk about the whole process that led me to my conclusion, to my culprits. From A to B. From 1 to 0.
Fucking run and spread the wrong narrative.
From 1 to 2. 3, 4, 5. From the beginning to the end. From the Genesis to the Apocalypse. Take with me, guys. The first thing, I needed a reason. All I needed was a reason. A black nigga not going to do any type of work if I don't have a reason. A lot of people just say that I just expose left, right because I feel like it or because I have issues with people. But to be honest, I only expose the sumun. If you're sumun, you're going to get exposed. If you like to do wrong, you will get exposed. Because a lot of people don't like to talk, but I will. A young nigga is not afraid to talk, you know? I only expose the people that love to create hate or drama or problems with people that don't have nothing, like unnecessary shit, you will get exposed. So the first motive was that he came into popularity by exposing underage niggas and bitches. His whole scheme was to take people's business, collect the infos, and put it out for the public. That was the recipe of SXM Academy. And I won't lie, this nigga made a lot of series though. It had the SXM Carnival Village Fights in 2018. It had the Meow Meow. It had the thing with the And of course, it had the Motopole Expo that he did just for fun. You imagine that? It had also the Red Eye Crew with the skeleton, with the it had a lot of events. Every time it had beef, drama, bullshit, that nigga would, like I said, take the people's business, collect the infos, and push it out to the public. That was the recipe. And the worst thing is that he had no valid reason to expose niggas like that. He was not getting paid for it. He had maybe no beef with the people he was exposing, no
wow.
problems with them, but he was just exposing people just because. Like I said, he would collect the infos and just redistribute it to the whole population. Even tease niggas with it. Ask niggas to follow his Snapchat or follow his Twitter to unlock this expose or this nude. I remember back then he wanted X amount of likes to unlock this post or this nude of this popular girl or this other popular boy or, you know, all type of bullshit and fuckeries, you know? on top of shit, you know? And to be honest, he was just giving a show to SXM people. Because I remember, you're not going to fool me now. Back then, exposing was a trend. It was fun to everybody. People used to expose anybody left, right, for free. You just needed WhatsApp, bro. People forwarding your shit for free. You know how many group chats on WhatsApp? Once it turned into one convo, it turned to a million convos. That shit done did the whole turn of SXM, bro. So I remember back then, people used to expose for fun, for free, with no filters. About, come see this new expose. He exposed that. Oh, that girl got exposed. Wow, another expose. But let me tell y'all something. Each person watching my video ever shared or exposed on WhatsApp, y'all exposing just like DJ Academics or all the other bitches and niggas who had beef with the people who they expose. So y'all as guilty as them. Because when you do not want to be a part of something, you do not share the bullshit, you know? So why share things that you are not like really like into? We have a culture of exposing in SXM, bro. Niggas and bitches love to expose. They don't want to see you shine. If they can expose your dick, my nigga, they will. If they can expose your panani, they will expose your panani, no cap. Niggas want to see what you got going on. Bitches want to see what you packing, you know? And that's why y'all will never see my dick online, you know? I don't need to send no snaps, you know? Come meet me. So anybody whoever shared a nude contributed to the exposing SXM chain, you know? So to be honest, all SXM Academics did was profit out of that system, and it's totally understandable, you know? But it's still low to me, because most of the exposed were underage girls my age, niggas my age, or even below. It's rarely grown people who were getting exposed, because in SXM they know who to expose. They know big people do not play that fuck, because as soon as you expose a big person or people who got knowledge in their brain, your ass will get sued. That's why I need to expose this nigga. Because he can do anything without getting any repercussions. No repercussion, because we don't know your identity. But that shit will stop right now, bitch. And the fact that this nigga was exposing anybody for no reason is the reason why I'm saying he's kind of merciless. Because you don't do wrong to anybody for no reason, just because you're behind a fake account. If you're genuine with people in general, you wanna be in that case or that scenario, bro. No. My second motive, bro, is that he came to me for no reason. I never had problem with SM Academics. I follow him once on Snapchat, because somebody tell me, yo, expose was popping. I wanted to see if he was really exposing people or not. I follow him once on Twitter, and when I see the things that what he was doing, I unfollow him. And after, when I start back chasing him, I follow him back, you know? And on Facebook, I just follow him, you know? But we had no static, we had no beef, we had no issues. So why you came to me for? Why? Y'all see the quality HD, y'all can't see me properly. Why? Let me rephrase that. Pourquoi? Pourquoi? Pourquoi t'es venu pour? Parce que tu es français, hein? Je sais que tu me comprends bien. D'autres people won't understand, mais je sais que tu m'entends là, tu me comprends. Pourquoi t'es venu? Pourquoi t'es venu derrière moi? Hein? SM Academics. Dis-moi. The only valid explanation I got for you is that he wanted to be in things too. When I was doing the whole Robinson thing, he made bunch of stories, I remember. It was a girl who like forwarded to me, because I was not even watching each story. I don't watch people's stories like that. Not going to cap. And he was sneak dissing, because he never mentioned me. He was sneak dissing like a bitch, you know? Me, when I have something to say, I just name the people I just talk about. I don't go behind people back and talk shit, bro. I just name them. I don't sneak this about he want to. No. I remember somebody came in my inbox, said SXM Academics is punching the air right now, and I just reposted. It was not me saying that. And the man came like, SXM Academics is punching the air right now. One thing I want to do is like, Kim, and show you all my personal DM. Y'all be waiting for this moment to talk about me, bitch. No. No. We don't even know who you are, bitch. I know way more than dude, and long time before the fuck you mean. I don't have to prove shit. This nigga literally went at the whole team lame as bitch because I add people I do not give to fucks. And I don't show my face too. Because I'm about what I'm saying. If you have to hide behind a fake account, my nigga, ask yourself some questions. You get no respect from me. Nigga ending up excusing itself and won't get mad cause I told him he lame for the first video because this nigga telling me I'm lame because I exposing Robinson shit. When he exposed 1,000 bitches and niggas, my nigga, you out of place. Know your fucking place. I ain't got no judge no more. So you know, all the frustration can come out like that. Know your fucking place. That's why I know who you are now. Know your fucking place. That's what you need to do. I told him he lame. For the first video, you lame as fuck, my boy. Period. By the way, nah, you know what? I'ma leave it there for next time. If I had to screenshot all my convos at the end, I would be there posting all week. Stop playing lol. I just didn't want to take where dude located. And unlike him, I've been speaking with them before even touching down SXM. We do not give two fucks. When you wrong, you gotta say it and shut the fuck up. That will avoid you of doing public apologies. My nigga, what my public apology got to do with your bitch ass, you know? You know? What it got to do with you? I know a lot of niggas don't like to apologize. Me, I don't have no problem apologizing because, you know, when I'm wrong, I just admit it that I'm wrong, you know? I do not hide behind, like, pride, ego, or fake profile. So shut your bitch ass up, you know? No, again, by the way, everybody talking about hip hop or VI artists, I'm the one who studied all this shit for you to even talk about and complain. If she grew book peanut, it cause of me. Nobody was fucking with rappers till I started supporting them. Get the fuck out of here. But anyways, man, y'all have fun with him. I'ma start posting other island artists. Lol, that's the last answer you getting from me. Bye. One thing that is funny with like SXM Academics. Is that he talking about he's the first person who found that artist or this artist, but who making a profit out of them? Not you. The most you can do is like promotions, and that is not every fucking day. The only people that really profit out of the artists is all the promoters. You found them, okay, cool, we do not give two fucks. Oh, I forgot the most important screenshot. I'm this other's wannabe's father. Bitch, you're not my father, bro. I'm your father, bro. I'm your daddy, bro. Call me daddy. No homo. Nigga following my footsteps. You even posting convos and erasing names and pics just like I did. What's next? Promo like me? Sincerely, your pops SXM Academy. That's what that nigga had to tell me, you know? And the answer for this would be like, why you mad? Why you mad? You saying I took your blueprint. Okay, do something about it. Don't be mad because I'm doing it better than you. That's it. The third motive is that he hiding behind a fake account. So all the wrong he causing got no repercussions, which is dangerous. Because if somebody ever gets that power of hurting anybody at any time without no consequences, oh my God. She will be untouchable and fierce. Because anybody know that if they have to like go against SXM Academics, they won't be able to like defend themselves or even just catch that nigga on the road to beat his cunt. They can't even do that because they don't have his identity. So either way, anybody that goes against SXM Academics will lose anyways. Because you can't fight somebody you do not know. You cannot expose somebody you do not know. You cannot talk about somebody you do not know. What can you do other than watch? So I found this aspect really unfair in my opinion. You cannot expose the whole SXM and get away with it.
No.
And right now, like, transform and transition your page to be like an info page of what's going on in SXM, blah blah blah. Like, bitch, we forgot where you came from. Like, that does work with real people, no? But when you expose people publicly online, that don't come out. That don't, you can't erase that, fuck no. It's not like somebody who like been in jail, robbed and thing, came back and want to start brand new. That is not the same thing, no. Because you never answer for your crimes. Again, if you went jail, you do your time, okay. We understand. But you never pay for anything you did. So you cannot transition just so.
Jesus Christ!
That's why I was looking and I looked for who and who are behind the SXM account. So all the things I did to find out who are behind. So first of all, the first thing I did is that I collect all the infos from everybody who does watch my videos. On February 19, I posted a story saying, if y'all got any infos on SXM Academics, y'all hit me up. Anything. We starting the manhunt from today, you know? And that was the answer to the stories that he posted about blah, blah, blah. He is my dad, blah, blah, blah. Okay, good. And to be honest, bro, I was shocked that so many people had their own theories and ideas of who is behind the SXM account and why they think this person or that person or those persons are behind the account. It had so many stories, so many blah blah blah. People were already doing their own investigations, you know? So the hunt was already up. And the thing that always came back is that he is a nigga, you know, and he's from Stanley Ground or FU. Always. He is older than us. He is not a little boy or a little girl, you know. And that's basically it. The only common point about most of the story is that some people were saying that he wants revenge, blah blah blah, or she wanted revenge. Other people brought a good point too. SXM Academics came up when it was popular and a trend to make fake accounts to expose niggas and bitches that you don't like, you know? Y'all remember that era when it had like fake Dora account, fake Diego account, fake Ariel, Mermaid, any type of bullshit, bro? Any type of fake characters was on Facebook exposing any type of niggas, creating fucking group chat, adding you out of nowhere. Bro, I remember 2018, 2017, I guess. I maybe got like 100 friend requests from fake profiles, bro. You know? I remember it had the voice of SXM. That was, y'all niggas forget about that, but that was one of the first exposed account, no? The voice of SXM. It had a lot of things, no? So, y'all cannot only blame SXM Academics, you know? Because compared to the others in that era, SXM Academics is the only one that really stand out and still remaining, you know? A lot of people was exposing the people they hated. And after that expose done, they leave go that account now. SXM Academics wanted more. So SXM Academics did not start the trend of having big balls behind a fake account. He is just the only one that remained till this day, you know, that stood out. So let me read a couple of like convos I got and things that I received. Some people say apparently he's from SG and he one of the big dogs. The big dogs from SG. The big dogs from SG know who he be. All I could say, the only way to find out who this man be is the location. What is the location? Location is like the IP address, you know, GPS location, you know. But to do that, you need to hack. Last year, a girl did expose few people and she said it's 3 people running the account, which is 2 girls and 1 boy. I know, but I don't think it's him. I did screenshot it and send it to SM Academics, but he didn't deny, which is strange. He just said, what is that? I believe I know who is SM Academics. Because I think SM Academics know me and I think he's a professional cameraman. Okay. A lot of people got a lot of fucking stories, and I believe it's a girl who does be doing the exposing. Like I said, I believe it's few people running the page. Boy, fam, at some point I was wondering if you hit SM Academics. Me, SM Academics? Do I look like a bitch ass nigga? No. So do not ever think it's me who is SM Academics. Bitch, I do not have the time. And I got a heart, bro. I don't expose anybody. I do not expose people. You know, all I do is not expose people. It's either promotion, you know. I do not expose people because y'all know who they are. They, y'all just like to forget and forgive. Nigga, I do not forget and I just rarely forgive, bro. That's just for the weak people, bro. And when I said, boy, leave the place, G, leave the place. I just say that because that was during the time I was doing the Robinson Shiggy videos, no. That shit funny. Boy, leave the place, you know? Somebody else say I get a new suspect. She got same way of writing. She probably in it. But if SXM Academics get exposed, it gonna get boring. That's why me hurt my head with that. The same way. After I see the same way of writing, interesting. After that person say, you see what happened? A girl comment and mention a next girl comment. Saying it's too early for this, that get my attention. Cause I check in, what she mean it's too early for this. So I click on her profile, she got the same way of typing like SM Academics. And comme par hasard, she is from Phillipsburg. So check SXM Academics and it's the same thing. So I was like, wow, you know. Somebody else say, I think that person is a girl. Honestly, at this point, I said, why would you think that? And that person said, because I remember one time the person said, I am doing them what they did to me, or something similar to that. They were referring to being exposed, unless if that person is a gay guy, you know? A lot of fucking theories, eh? People sending me screenshots after they telling me they're not getting paid for this. Somebody else said, and the person must be from Marigot or SG area, not Dutside, because if you pay attention to the way they put out the Dutside nudes, there's no hype compared to the French side. That's a great statement. That's a great statement. After that person say I'm overly exposing shit. Somebody else said that person gave feminine vibes. And I won't lie to y'all, I had the same thought. Because the way that person was exposing them people on Twitter, it was so feminine. It was like so, like, how can I say that? It was so emotional, like that person, like it's really like that person was doing them. I don't know how to explain, but at that point, when I was seeing the expose on Twitter, I was thinking that person was either a gay guy, a gay person from Sunny Ground or wherever, like, it's either Sunny Ground or like the third step where you got like gay people. But to be honest, it was either a gay guy or a girl, bro. The way that person was talking and doing all that for sport and thing, feminine vibes, you know? But he was aggressive too, so that's why I don't know. The second thing I did was watch all his posts from the beginning. Even though he had another account before that. All from Facebook, Twitter, IG, Snapchat account. But y'all get the idea. And I found a couple of things, you know. The first thing, I wanted to see if he really from the French side or the Dutch side. So I did my research. And first of all, the first thing that is a proof that he is from the French side, he is a French fellow, is that when he used to do his screenshots in 2018, at the beginning, his screenshots were in French, you know? His Facebook is in French, my nigga, you know? It's not comments, it's commentaires, you know? It's not screenshots, it's capture d'écran, you know? The second thing, the man, at the beginning and middle of like his journey, used to mostly post French-style rappers and French-style exposed and French side gossip and French side drama. It was always based on the French side. The hype for the French side was not the same that from the Dutch side. After I get it a little bit, because French side, we had it. But come on, it got a lot of drama on the Dutch side too. But that was not the main focus, or he or she. It was not it main focus, you know? Like I said, third, his whole Facebook is in French. His phone is in French. His phone is so in French that in 2018, when he posted one of his first YouTube videos about the SXM Carnival Village fight, where he screen record the fight from out of DJ Maestro. That shit was not only in French, but the network that he had was a French side network, bro. La Poste Mobile. First of all, La Poste is from the French side. So we can already eliminate the Dutch side. Second of all, that shit do not exist in SXM or in fucking Guadeloupe, you know? I do not know about Martinique, but I doubt that it exists in Martinique. That thing is only pure French metropolitan, you know? That network is only French, France, Metropolitan. That little thing is like connected to SFR. SFL do not exist, do not have no fucking spots in Saint Martin or Guadeloupe. That nigga was in 2018 in fucking France. So people who are accusing niggas and bitches from the Dutch side, unless if it's somebody who is from the French side living on the Dutch side, y'all can eliminate them terrorism because he is not from the Dutch side. And that means that person was one of those person was in 2018 already in France. So when that person was doing all that rah-rah-rah shit in 2018-2019, that person was done nothing in 6M. That person was already in France. So if y'all want to lead before I tell too much, y'all trace it. If the carpet that you think in your head that I think that you have was not in France already in 2018, eliminate them because it's not them. So that person was in France for sure from 2018, maybe before 2018 too, You cannot eliminate that fact or that possibility. So if we want to push that theory further than that, that person was maybe from maybe 2018, maybe 2017, 2016. But you know, in 2018, that person was in France. And maybe till 2021, that person was still in France. Maybe came back for vacation, maybe came back, or I don't know. But that person was living in France, you know. During the carnival, during the Dutch side carnival, which is in April. That means if that person who was in France already in 2018, April, means that person came in France in 2017 maybe, because the school year in France does start September. So that person was already in France in September 2007 for sure, if he is a student or something, you know. So I won't lie, we tried to hack his page, but that bitch ass nigga is smart. My boys tried to send shits, but he never clicked on no fucking links. You pissing me off. I won't lie, I tried to hire a hacker, you know, on the
what do you mean by
you know that? On the, you know, but there is no guarantee that person will not finesse my money, you know, or that person will try all his best to expose or let expose or to find out or to hack the account after I pay him. So that was too risky for me, even though I won't give y'all the carpet and thing. I don't have no guarantee of getting my money back or getting the service done, you know. So that was out of the question, you know. I cannot lose my hard-earned guap for like a maybe, you know. I cannot do that. Because to hire a hacker is a lot of money. It's not a lot of money. But in my situation, I'm not a rich ass nigga, you know. I'm about to become rich, you know. And why I'm about to become rich is because I know how to handle my money well. Not making dumb decisions. So like I said, I look at every single post from the beginning. You know, the genesis, you know. And I won't lie, I was looking for one little mistake, you know. Because from 2018 to 2021, bitch, nobody is perfect. Nobody is untouchable. We are all humans, so we all do mistakes. Of course, I will find out that mistake, you know. I would have find it. And the funny fact is that as soon as I found that mistake, he repeated that same mistake couple of times. I was like, bingo, I know who that person. Anyways, I won't keep y'all waiting any longer. So the person, y'all watch me go. So the culprits behind N6M Academic account are in fucking
many secret patties later.
Yo, after editing my video, bro, as y'all can see, and learning from my past mistakes on YouTube, I've decided to not reveal who are behind SXM Academy just yet, because there is always room for errors and we never got enough evidence. But if you really want me to name drop, I'm gonna need 300 likes. If y'all want me to name drops the two culprits I got there, y'all give me 300 likes and I'm doing it right now. Until then, y'all send me all the infos y'all got that can benefit me in anything, because maybe it won't go with what I got in mind and maybe it will, because I got two culprits now. I got two niggas. niggas. Two niggas. Y'all hit my DM. Like I said, I need 300 likes and I'm name dropping right now. And all I'm gonna say to give y'all some hints, the people behind the SXM Academic account are not from the Dutch side, not from Senegal, and not from FQ. Gang gang. So if you knew, you know what to do. Subscribe, hit a notification bell, cause I treat my clients well, and 300 likes for me to name drop, you know, on gang.
Yeah, she test.
Wait, can you say that again? 19-year-old sad boy?
Sad boy.
Is that like a genre now? Sad boy genre?
Please, I don't have any time for any gossip now. Mm-hmm. Eh? Yes.
Look at you.